Welcome back, Tigers. In this video, we're going to review our recommendations for managing contacts in Salesforce. We will cover common scenarios we see when working with our customers in a B2B environment. We will answer the following questions. What happens when a contact changes companies or if they retire? What is the best way to merge duplicates? How do you set up contacts so you can easily find the ones you want to target for a webinar invite or an email communication? We'll cover all of this and more. Let's hop over to Salesforce and see how to manage our contacts. All right, here we are in Salesforce. We're on a contact record. And the first step to effectively managing your contacts is you need to create a couple of fields that will allow you to manage the status of a contact. You can see here we have a field called contact status. This is just a pick list with two different values for active and inactive. Then if I choose inactive, I have a second pick list field here called inactive reason. This allows me to specify the reason that the contact is no longer active. Now these two fields do have a dependency between them, and I can show you what that looks like in the back end of Salesforce here. We'll go into setup. We'll go to fields, and then we have a field dependency set up between our contact status and our inactive reason. So whenever the user chooses inactive in our contact status, they will also see this drop down to let them select a reason. Now, another field that you may want to look at creating is a primary contact field. And we have encountered companies who need a way to identify more than one primary contact for a particular company. Rather than creating a whole bunch of primary contact lookup fields on the account record, we recommend creating a checkbox on the contact object that will allow the user to identify more than one of these people. So we'll just create a checkbox here. Call it primary contact. And then we have this checkbox right here. So now we can identify more than one person as a primary contact. And then we can also use this field to filter for email communications or webinar invites when we want to target only the primary contacts for a particular company. Now, another scenario we're asked about a lot is how to manage contacts when they change companies. What we see a lot of people do is they'll come to the contact record and just change the account name. So let's say that Marticia is moving from the Addams Family to Walt Disney World. They'll just come in here and change the account name over to Walt Disney World and click save. Now, this messes up all of your historical information. It makes it look like all of the activities that are related to Marticia occurred when she was at Walt Disney World, which is not true. We've got two opportunities that are related to the Addams Family. We've got a task over here. So it really makes your historical information very confusing for a user when they come back in behind you and look at this. What we recommend doing in this scenario is you would leave Marticia at the Addams Family. You would just mark this contact as inactive. Say that she left the company. You click save. Then you would go to Walt Disney World and you would create a new contact record for Marticia. Now Marticia's title is probably different, her department's probably different, phone number is different, and email is different. So it really makes sense for you to create a new contact in this scenario. If we go back to the old contact, sometimes we also see people remove email addresses, phone numbers, titles. You don't want to remove any of that either. You want to make sure that you have a record of which email address is no longer valid, which titles are no longer valid, and leave her contact record intact. Another thing that you may run into while managing your contacts and working with them in Salesforce is the need to have dropdowns to filter for people who are in a specific department or management level. It is really impossible to use title to filter for specific people in a report. We've seen people try and you just end up having to have so many different combinations of a particular title and you never get everybody. We recommend creating two dropdowns, one for department and one for management level. This will allow you to use these pick lists in your filtering for your reports. So let's go ahead and come on the contact, and we're going to create a field called management level. And we're going to use the values that we see in Zoom info: C-level, VP level, director, manager, and non-manager. We've also seen people add other values like board member. If you have others that you find helpful, you can go ahead and add those. All right, then we'll refresh our screen over here. And our field is not showing, so we're going to do a little trick that we heard from David Massey. We're going to switch this from compact to comfy and then flip it back. And what that does is it forces your page to automatically refresh. Thanks, Kirby, for the tip on that. Okay, here we can see our management level field, and this would be C-level. Now you may be thinking, Cheryl, you're nuts. I've got 20,000, 100,000 contacts in my database. How am I going to get all of these people updated? You're just going to get through it, and it'll be totally worth it. You're first going to clean up your contact database and only update the ones that need to be updated. The active ones, the ones that are your customers. Maybe you don't do your prospects. Maybe you do your prospects, but you have to make a plan to get these updated. It is going to save you time in the long run. And then you need to have a plan by which you follow. Whenever you're importing contacts, you always specify values in these two fields. You will also probably want to make these two fields required if anybody is going to create a new contact in Salesforce. Make a plan, set a date, spend maybe an hour or two a week updating your contacts. You can export them to Excel, filter them by title, sort them by title, do a find. Everybody with operations or chief in the title is going to get department equal to operations and management level equal to C-level. Doesn't have to be exactly perfect. You know, you're gonna might maybe have some errors when you do it in Excel like that, but you're gonna be a lot closer than you would be if you're trying to filter for people based on title alone. Now we're gonna cover some scenarios that you may run into when you see duplicates in Salesforce. Now, we don't have any kind of indication telling us that there's more than one Morticia Adams in Salesforce on our page here. We actually have three different Morticias. So this tells me that I am missing my potential duplicates component from my Lightning record page. We'll go to our contact record page, and then we're going to add this component. Click save. And then we'll refresh our contact record. And then we can see the card is showing up here, and we have a little toaster here at the top. This tells us that there's more than one duplicate, and we can see that there's two Morticias at different companies. Now, it's not finding the third Morticia, and this is because the third Morticia has not triggered the duplicate rules in this org. So in order for this type of merging in Lightning to show up in the card on the contact, it has to trigger the duplicate rules that you have within your org. So there are going to be scenarios where you need to merge contacts, but you don't get this pop-up on that contact. Now, another nice thing about merging in Lightning is you can merge contacts from two different companies. You will not be able to do this in Classic. So we'll hit next, and then you can select which data you want to keep from each record. And then those get merged. And then we get this message here: we found no potential duplicates of this contact. Now, since we have the standard duplicate and matching rules enabled in this org, this is not going to cover all of our scenarios, and we're going to find duplicates that don't trigger those rules. So we're going to have to figure out a different way to merge contacts when the rules are not triggered. Now, we're going to show you a couple of different ways to do this. Now, let's go and check out our duplicates here first. So we've got two different Morticias. And let's say that this Morticia is a duplicate and we need to merge these two together. Well, it's not triggering the duplicate rules, so we need to switch over to Classic to merge these records. So this is the one Morticia. Let's go to the other one. We need the Morticia at Walt Disney World. And we're going to edit this Morticia, and we need to move her over to the Adams family. Because we cannot merge records, contact records. They are related to different accounts in Classic. They have to be at the same account. Now we can go to the account and we can hover over here. We can click merge contacts and then we can merge them. We'll select the two duplicates. And now these two are merged. So it's a lot of steps for you to be able to merge in Classic. Now we have a little trick that we're gonna show you where we're gonna create a custom button that will allow you to open the contact up in Classic. It's gonna shorten your steps by a couple, but we see people run into this a lot. We are switching to Classic at least a couple of times a week to be able to merge contacts. So we find this button to be super helpful. All right, so we're going to switch back to Lightning and we'll go into Setup. We're gonna go to Home. We're gonna go to Visual Force Pages. You're gonna create a new Visual Force page. You'll call it whatever you want. We're calling ours Open Account Detail Page in Classic. We will give you this code in the description below. It's super simple. So you're just gonna replace everything here with the code that we give you. And that's it, that's the page. So this is just going to open up the account detail page in Classic. Our next step is to go to Object Manager and you will go to your contact object. You go to Buttons, Links, and Actions. You're gonna create a new button and then we'll give you the button URL in the description below as well. This is the syntax of the URL. And then this right here is just the name of your Visual Force page. So whatever you called your page, this is what you'll need to put in here. And then we're going to call this button Merge Contact in Classic. We'll make it a detail page button and we want it to display in a new window. You can choose what kind of behavior you want to happen. We'll click Save. Now we need to add that button to our contact page layout. We'll go to Mobile and Lightning Actions. And then we'll drag and drop our Merge Contact in Classic button onto the layout. All right, now we're back at our account record and I'm going to create a duplicate contact really fast here for Morticia. And this one is not going to trigger the duplicate rules. So we can see here there's not enough information or not enough of the same information between the two contacts. First name and last name match is not enough. And we are not able to merge these from Lightning. So we can see over here, yes, indeed, we do have two Morticias. So now we can use our fancy button. We go to the contact. We click Merge Contact in Classic, and then we can hover over our contacts, click Merge Contacts, select both of our Morticias, and click Merge. You would, of course, select which data you want from each contact record first. And now we have our cleaned up list. Now, if you did have two different contacts that were at two different accounts, you would have to move those to the same account before you'd be able to merge them in Classic. All right, and that's it. We hope we've given you a lot of tips and tricks that will help you better manage your contact database in Salesforce. That's it, that's a wrap. Be sure to subscribe to Blue Tiger Academy so you don't miss the next video we are working on that will show you how to identify old contacts that can be deleted safely. You may find yourself wanting to clean up Salesforce to remove old contacts who have changed companies or are retired. While cleaning up records is the right thing to do, you need to check to see if the contacts have related records before deleting. Let us know in the comments below if you have any questions or if you would like to see a video on a different Salesforce topic. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.